Philippine government allows children age 5 and above in outdoor areas like alfresco dining establishments, outdoor tourist sites, beaches, hiking trails, and playgrounds. Presidential spokesman Harry Roque says the policy will be implemented in areas under General Community Quarantine or GCQ and Modified General Community Quarantine or MGCQ, except for places under GCQ with heightened restrictions such as Cavite and Laguna. Outdoor areas of places like malls, which are considered mixed-use establishments, are still off-limits to children. When in outdoor areas, children must be supervised by adults and wear face masks. They must also observe physical distancing. Local governments are also authorized to modify the age range of kids allowed in outdoor public places depending on the COVID-19 situation in their respective jurisdictions. The decision to lift movement restrictions on kids is a result of government's efforts to boost economic activity. Trade Secretary Ramon Lopez previously said a big chunk of economic activity in commercial establishments is driven by families with young children. The World Bank apologizes to the Philippine government and takes down a report on its website describing poor learning results among Filipino students. This comes after Education Secretary Leonor Briones earlier demanded an apology from the World Bank. Briones earlier claimed the World Bank did not follow protocol in releasing the report and cited outdated figures in the study. Finance Secretary Sonny Dominguez backed up Briones, blasting the World Bank for its lack of professionalism. The report enumerates gaps in the Philippines' education sector, such as a majority of 15-year-olds do not understand fractions. The report also says only 10% of Filipino 5th graders were at par with global standards due to students' limited proficiency in English. The World Bank concluded there was a crisis in education in the Philippines, which started even before the coronavirus pandemic. Political party PDP-Laban expels its own vice chairman, Energy Secretary Alfonso Cusi, and Secretary General Melvin Matibag for allegedly supporting the presidential candidacy of a party outsider, Davao City Mayor Sara Duterte. PDP-Laban President Senator Manny Pacquiao signed separate resolutions expelling Cusi, Matibag, and membership committee head Asa Naik, and declares as void the National Assembly held last May 31 and the upcoming Assembly on July 17. The resolution accuses Cusi of maneuvering to allow the party to push for a Duterte-Duterte tandem. Pacquiao's group says it's tantamount to party disloyalty. The May 31 National Assembly was convened by Cusi and boycotted by Pacquiao. The PDP-Laban members adopted a resolution calling on President Duterte to run for vice president. PDP-Laban Party Chairman President Rodrigo Duterte, who said he would seriously consider running for vice president, recognizes the resolution adopted during the National Assembly. Duterte and other PDP-Laban members also recently expressed support for the presidential bid of party auditor Senator Bongo. Meanwhile, photos of Senators Ping Lacson and Tito Sotto kneeling on the pews of Barasoain Church pop on social media. A Lacson-Sotto tandem in the 2022 elections is already cast in stone, with the two senators saying they will only run with each other. Sotto adds he and Lacson are going on a consultative tour with local officials in Luzon, the Visayas, and Mindanao. Going to the Barasoain Church in Bulacan kicks off their Luzon consultative tour. Pole vaulter E.G. Obiena and judoka Kiyomi Watanabe are chosen as the Philippines' opening ceremony flag bearers in the Tokyo 2020 Olympics. Obiena and Watanabe will represent the 19-athlete delegation by carrying the flag in the event opener on July 23. Obiena was the first Tokyo 2020 Olympics qualifier from the Philippines and is a prime medal bet for a podium finish. Obiena eclipsed the Philippine national record twice in the outdoor season, recording a new mark of 5.87 meters days before Tokyo 2020. Meanwhile, Japan declares a state of emergency following a new wave of COVID-19 infections, causing Olympics organizers to ban all spectators. The ban on spectators marks the latest blow to the troubled event, which is already delayed by a year because of the pandemic and plagued by massive budget overruns. Global K-pop sensation BTS drops the music video to their latest English language single, Permission to Dance, on Friday, July 9. The upbeat dance track is part of the group's Butter single CD. Among those who co-wrote Permission to Dance is British singer-songwriter Ed Sheeran. Sheeran and BTS had collaborated before on the track Make It Right, which is part of BTS's album Map of the Soul Persona, released in April 2019. The Permission to Dance music video on HYBE label's YouTube channel has over 20 million views and counting. This is the third English language single of the group, following the release of Butter in May 2021, which broke at least 5 Guinness World Records, and Dynamite.